good to go.
Yes.
So above a normal massive stretch of shops in Chicago sat a maze of hallways and staircases connecting soundproof rooms and trap doors. Blueprints for this mansion included body-sized chutes leading to a kiln-containing basement, a total of 100 windowless rooms, airtight chambers, and 51 doorways that opened to nothing but a brick wall. The structure impersonated a hotel and lured in visitors, typically young women, into its treacherous and murderous doors. It stood active throughout 1893 until my birthday on November 17th, 1894. That's something really fun for me. When its owner was arrested. It was the carefully crafted home of H.H. Holmes, who was deemed to be America's first serial killer. So according to federal law, the United States Congress defines serial killings as a series of three or more killings, not less than one of which was committed within the United States, having common characteristics as to suggest the reasonable possibility that the crimes were committed by the same actor or actors. Although H.H. Holmes receives the first title of the first serial killer in the United States, it is assumed that others of this kind had previously existed but had not been properly analyzed or categorized as a serial offender. This is a small highlight of a major problem in the U.S. The United States of America is the serial killer capital of the world. According to FBI statistics, 67.58% of all known serial murderers in the last 116 years worldwide were from the United States. So to give you some context, China contains 19% of the world's population and had a total of 57 serial killers, so 19%. The US is only 4.4% of the world's population, yet in the same 116 years was home to 3,204 serial killers. So there's a plethora of specific reasons for this phenomena, which run too deep and are too complex to dive into during this speech. What I wish to foster through my speech is a new way of thinking about this phenomenon. I wish to push this problem into a new light. Scary stories and the recurring and recounting horrors are unliked by some but enjoyed by many. The tall tales of horrible things that seem far off and distant from reality are fascinating. We romanticize events and make them into scary movies or monsters we tell our younger siblings about. It is fun to disconnect from reality and feel safe to giggle at distress. Real accounts, survivor stories, crime scene photos, and victim impact statements, however, don't quite captivate Americans in the same way. Herein lies the problem. We have a real outstanding trend of serial killers committing savage acts in outrageous numbers, and our nature of casting off reality and being captivated by the unknown only feeds the problem. It is too real for Americans. We cannot disconnect and analyze a problem when we know that it is an active problem. We like to wait for the phenomena to either be solved or calm down and then romanticize the story and spread it like wildfire across the media in the form of a book or a movie. Right now, the FBI's elite serial crime unit estimates that there are at least 25 and at most 50 active serial killers in the United States. If you're the average American, you, for one, probably hate that I just informed you of that statistic. And two, are unsettled by those numbers. And three, you can only name serial killers like Ted Bundy and the Zodiac Killer that are irrelevant to your safety today. This highlights my point in the extent to which we cast off the terrible acts committed by our fellow humans on our fellow humans. So what is the problem with neglecting serial killers? We all agree that murder is bad and we all hate a serial killer. But in neglecting a serial killer, you directly neglect their crimes and the victim of those crimes. You neglect the families of the victims, the sequence of the crime. You ignore and neglect the fact that this act took place and that people or peoples are either dead or forever changed because of it. You place the power in the hands of the assailant because you choose to ignore rather than analyze. This is why we see such a phenomenal problem with serial killers in the United States of America. We more often than not choose to put these horrid things out of our minds rather than stop, think, analyze, and try to prevent these acts in the first place. I've always been fascinated by the morbid, and maybe that's why I have such an inclination to criminal justice and criminology. However, it's not just a problem solved by the few people who decide to work as criminal profilers and detectives. It's a social issue, a stigmatized way of thinking that facilitates this problem in the US. To aid in fixing this problem, we must all understand that casting off a serial killer casts off their victims, and that ignoring a problem never helps to solve it. We must remember that all parties involved are humans and that all actions committed are not committed in a vacuum without reason. We all hate a serial killer, but we must grasp that we are all part of a society which facilitates them.